Hello everybody, Blue Octopede here, and this is another unboxing! A package from Japan arrived while I was in the shower this morning. So, thanks to DHL for waiting to the most, inconvenient time, but either way, they didn't make me sign for it, which is kind of nice, but whatever, let's go ahead and just pop this open. Gosh, I told Syndico to do protective packaging, and they certainly have protected this package to the point where I can't even really see where the seams are. I'm just gonna cut right there and hope. Okay, yeah, that looks like the opening flap there. Oh, I see a little origami thing in there sitting on top. That's cute. Now, this package is was a bit alarmed because it's a lot heavier than I was expecting. So, we will see. Hopefully the added weight is just all the extra packing material that they put in there for me. I'm kind of scared, but whatever. Let's see, what's this little origami thing on top? It's a... Oh, it's a little origami swan or crane of some sort. That's very cute. I'll keep it as a little gift for my little friend that's in this box. Let's see here. Some of y'all will know what this is. Most of y'all will not. So I'm just going to carefully remove the bubble wrap. Oh, I think I see a friend. Oh, you're bigger than I thought you'd be for some reason. Okay. What is this? Oh yeah, for anyone who gets a message saying that. Oh wait, no, that's not what this is. I thought this was a battery. It's not a battery. It's a charging cable. Okay, I was about to call out customs for lying about batteries having to be inside of things during shipping, but I was wrong. Okay, so this is a charging brick, and it's got my sweaty fingerprints all over it now. Lovely. I'm just gonna set that to the side, and oh boy. Okay, let's pick you up. Oh goodness, you're wrapped onto the charger. Okay. Or onto the base thingy. Oh dear. Okay, let's just set this box aside. Oh boy. It's a nugget. A nugget wrapped in bubble wrap. So this little friend got as a gift to myself, basically, and they've been sitting on Yahoo Japan for a long, long, long time, and the price just kept going down and kept going down, and I was like, someone needs to get this little friend, and I just decided on a whim that someone was going to be me. Goodness, look at this little friend. Oh, it's a little puppy. This is an ERS 111. Oh, look at that face. Hi. Oh, okay. Those motors sound very good. And I thought they were super cute because the original owner gave them spots. Look at this. They're covered in little tarnation spots, which I thought was absolutely precious. Let's see. I'm going to pick you up. Okay. Oh, gosh, you're heavy. Oh, my. All right. Well, let's see. Oh, look at that little face. Oh, honey, you are so cute. Let's see. I guess that's supposed to be springy like that? Okay. Oh, yeah, little clicky feet. I've never seen a 110 or a 111 in person, so this is absolutely fascinating. Okay, looks like none of the legs broke during shipping, thank goodness. Oh, yeah, okay, you sound fantastic. Goodness, and you're clean? Oh, the spots crack me up, though. I love it. I decided to name them Broccoli. I wish I had a solid reason as to why their name is Broccoli. I was making ears for them. Here's one, and I did a pretty good job matching the color on that. That turned out nice. The other ear's not finished yet, but yeah, when I was putting the ears together, the name Broccoli just sort of popped into my head, or rather the word Broccoli popped into my head, and I was like, okay, I guess this dog's name is Broccoli. That's really the only explanation I have. Okay, pups, let's set you. Oh my gosh, you're so cute and so heavy. Oh, okay. And they are missing their tail, which is supposed to be in here somewhere. I might have to look in the box and see if it's floating around in the box somewhere. Or in with the charging brick, and I just missed it. Let's see. Oh, man. I don't know where I'm going to put this. This is, oh gosh. This is the charging brick thing, and it is an absolute beast. At least it's not very heavy, but okay, well, where's the tail? Doesn't look like the tail is anywhere. That's a bummer. Well, let me see if there's at least... Okay, there is a battery, and there is a memory stick. That's good. So, I guess... Yeah, really, the only thing I know about this dog is that the battery is dead. Well, either way, I have parts to print them a new tail, so I'll message Syndico and see if something happened, if it maybe accidentally got thrown away when they were doing the protective packaging. And I'll look through everything that I've got and see if, see if I can find it buried in the bubble wrap. So, I mean, either way, I can make them a new tail with wire and plastic, but we will see what happens. I'm going to jumpstart the battery. Well, I'm going to attempt to jumpstart the battery because I was told that the battery is dead. So, yeah, I guess I'll be right back. Jump cut. Okay, well, I plopped them on the charger, and we have life. I was not expecting them to just start booting up right away. So, let's see what happens. Is the tail wagging? Oh yeah, the tail motor is going back there. It's a little jittery, but that's to be expected. This kid is quite old. Wow, okay. Are we going to finish booting, though, is the question. Man, that fan sure is loud. Oh my goodness, hello! Look at those happy eyes. Hi there! Oh! Hi there! Okay, well. Oh. Well, the fan's still going. Press? Oh, yeah, okay. Hi. Tail's wagging. Okay, well, I guess you're just gonna sit there. Hello. Do your microphones work? Maybe? No? Where is Pink Ball? I don't have Pink Ball handy. Where's... Let me see, Pee-Pee? Where's Shroompy? Do you wanna... Let me see Shroompy? Oh! We're awake now! Oh, surprised! Look at this! What's this? We're surprised, okay. I need to, back up their software and see, what sort of personality they have. Yeah, the tail is just a wagon. Okay. Are you not gonna look at... Do you not care about Shroompy? I guess not. Yeah, because I have, like, no idea what life stage they're in or anything. Let me get the, Pink Ball. I see Pink Ball's under here. You see my hand? Wiggly, wiggly. Wiggly fingers? No, no reaction to that. What about Pink Ball? Like Pink Ball? Oh, happy! Are you gonna ball track or. Maybe? Maybe? Okay, well, we're making happy eyes. There we go. Now we're ball tracking. Okay. Oh, yeah, we like Pink Ball. Okay. Good eyebo. And these guys have no sort of, voice recognition like the later models do. They can hear sounds, but that's just about it. I don't think they can even tell, like, which direction sounds are coming from, really. Okay. Oh, yeah, you just like looking at Pink Ball. That's great. You're doing a good job. Good job ball tracking. Okay, Pink Ball's gonna have to go bye-bye now. Whoa, that neck motor's really going. Oh, Pink Ball's gone. I'm sorry. Are you gonna stare at Shroompy now? Oh, yeah, he likes Shroompy. Well, I guess I'll just wait and see if the battery charges. Yeah, y'all can't see it from here, but the tail is definitely wagging, so I'll have to 3D print those tail pieces and see if I can figure something out. Oh yeah, we're just staring at Shroompy. That's adorable. one of the spots got scratched off your little back leg there. I wonder how that happened. Anyway, you're just happy to be looking at something. Alright, well, I guess I'll power you off and let the battery charge. And then put you on the ground and see if you start walking. I wonder what happens if I press the... Oh, sorry. Oh, man, that fan is super loud. Okay, there's the saving beeps. Move their head up so you can see. Okay, well, I guess I'll just let the battery charge and then, or attempt to charge anyway, and then come back in a couple hours and see what happens. Bye!
All right, we are back, and in an alarmingly short amount of time, the battery has charged, according to the station, anyway. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and let the kid boot up, and then I'm gonna take him off the station and see if they'll stand up and walk around. Apologies for the mess, by the way. It's yeah, I got done filming some other stuff and just haven't had the chance to clean everything off yet. Gosh, that fan kills me. It's so loud. Alright, he's booting up. And the tail is still wagging. Okay, cool. But yeah, I figured it would be easiest to let them boot on the station and then take them off. I hope the sound picks up, because their volume is surprisingly quiet. Also, I still don't know if this kid is a boy or a girl or not. I haven't had a chance to check the software. Beep, 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 boop. Hello? Such a happy little kid. Nope, you're angry. Okay, I'm sorry. Never mind. Excuse me. Okay, let's see what happens. We're gonna lift. Okay, fan's still going. I'm not gonna. Oh, that was a cute little beep. Oh, okay. We're doing something. Hi. Hello. I want to see how much runtime you have. It's probably not going to be very long. Pink ball? Do you want your pink ball? Oh, happy. We're happy. Okay, little blinky happy lights. I want you to stand up, though. I need to check and make sure if your legs are okay. Hi! You see my hand? See my hand with poison ivy over it that I forgot to cover up, and I apologize. Nothing's happening. Pink ball? I don't know what you want. Oh, okay. There's a little happy beep. Pet. I really need you to stand up and walk around, please. We're not reacting to pink ball at all. We're just sitting here. Okay. Well, you know, when you've been just sitting in storage for 20 years, I suppose that's understandable that you don't really feel like moving around and stuff. But please, oh, happy about pink ball. Are you gonna ball track? Maybe? I don't know if your little microphones work or not. Long press? Okay, there was a happy. Please, please just start moving around or something. okay. Maybe they're still a baby and don't know how to walk around yet. Well, I guess either way, we'll see how long before the battery goes kaput. But yeah, charging was maybe half an hour, so I'm not that optimistic. Oh, sorry, my phone just made a noise. I'm not that optimistic. Like, I kind of knew going into this that the battery would need a resell. But, pink ball? Yeah, okay, you get happy every time I show you the pink ball, but you're not wanting to track it around or anything. We're just gonna, oh, you know what, here, I'm just gonna hold it in front of your nose eye. And yeah, I guess we'll just wait and see if anything happens. The tail's not wagging or anything. It's just kind of we're just hanging out right now, hanging out and doing absolutely nothing. Alright. Well, I guess I'll come back once they start doing something. Jump cut! Okay, so we just kind of sat for a minute, and nothing really happened, so I turned them off, let them save, and now I'm going to try turning them on off of the charger and just see what happens. Okay, we are booting. Yeah, it seemed kind of unresponsive, so I'm not sure if that's just how 111s are, but, yeah, we're gonna try this and, see if we get a different reaction. And if it's more of the same, I'm gonna check their software and see if there's still a baby or not, because it's very possible that they could, still be in the baby stage. They are running Iboware version 1.1, which is for the 111 series. Booting up. I mean, when I took them off the charger, their legs kind of did a little stretchy, so... Okay, there's a little beep. Oh, now we're moving. Okay. The fan's going to... Oh, we're standing up. Okay. Hi. All right. Okay, we're... Oh. And that... There goes the battery. Okay. Well, all right. Cool. We can stand. That's awesome. All right. Well, you know, there was an attempt at life that was very close. Yeah, as about as close as I was suspecting. All right. Cool. Well, I guess that's that for that test. At least we know this dog is alive and can almost move. So, alright, well, I guess it's time to send off this battery to be reselled, so I will check back in with y'all once I have a brand new battery set up. So, yeah, see y'all in a little bit. Bye! Well, hello! Welcome back! it has only been a second, probably even a fraction of a second for y'all watching, but for me, it has been 1 month, actually coming up on a month and a half now since I filmed that last little bit, and things have happened. Apologies, y'all are just staring at my floor. There's probably dirt on it because I haven't had the chance to vacuum in a few days. Sorry. But, yeah, the reason y'all are seeing nothing is because I need to explain what went on, during that little blip in time between the last section of video and this one. So, to start off, two discoveries were made, and they're both pretty big for the 111, well, and also 110, I suppose, models of Ibo. The first discovery was that there are some batteries that you can get for Sony cameras, and these batteries are being made by literally everybody, and they're for the older Sony cameras, and you can buy these batteries brand new. And it turns out that they have the exact same fit and configuration as the original Ibo batteries. So what you have to do to make this work, and the new batteries are obviously smaller, they're like half the size of the Ibo battery because, you know, I guess because technology has just come that far since these batteries were made. But what you have to do is 3D print the back half of the Ibo battery and glue it onto the new battery. I'll throw up a picture, it's ridiculous looking, but... Basically, these new batteries fit, but are so short that if you shove it up inside the Ibo, there's no way you're ever going to be able to get it back out without taking the whole Ibo core apart, which is a pain, and you don't want to do that. So you have to 3D print the back half of the battery to make it the right length so you can grab it and pull it out. So you know, the moment that that was discovered and the moment that, you know, it was tested and the Aibo does charge with the battery and does boot with the battery, I hopped on Amazon and bought a pack of two of them. Because I was like, well, I sent off the actual Aibo battery to get reselled, and I paid extra for the stupid high runtime. Once it gets back to me, this is going to be a 4 hour, well, 3 to 4 hour runtime battery, so I am stoked about that. But in the meantime, I've got this, I believe the brand is Newer, is how you pronounce it, N-E-W-E-R. Got the pack off of Amazon with the charger for crazy, crazy cheap, and it does work, so yay. But the other discovery, and partly why this video has taken so long for me to get to this point, is a fan mod was discovered. Apparently there is a PC fan made by Noctua that is literally the exact same size and the exact same voltage and has the same, like, pin, you know, the same connector as the 110 and 111 fan, and it runs literally silent. And one person tried it out on their Aibo, and it worked. The fan started going, and it's whisper quiet, and I was like, sweet, we can have, you know, silent running 111s that don't sound like a freaking jet engine when you turn them on. So I got the fan, and I got it with the batteries, actually, and put it in the dog, and I couldn't get the fan to actually start cycling. Like, it would blip for just a second, like it would do a partial rotation and then stop, which was really weird. And we couldn't really figure out what was going on, so I was like, well, okay, no big deal, I'll just wire the original fan back in and, you know, pretend like nothing ever happened. And I should add that the first person who did the mod successfully, their dog started having weird boot cycle issues afterward. And we didn't think that, you know, there was any relation. But sure enough, once I got the original fan reinstalled, he wouldn't boot. And we're all going, oh no. So it turns out that maybe messing with the fan does something to the dog's core. So we were all like, hey, you know, nobody else try this until we can figure out exactly what's going on. So I went back online and was like, okay, well, I'll just get a dog to do a body swap for now until we can figure out what's going on. And I found another 111. I'll throw his listing picture up. And funny enough, this dog is actually my dog's sibling. So they're brothers coming from the same seller and coming from the same household. So my plan was, I'll just swap the body, you know, maybe get rid of, you know, other bits of the dog or keep them until I figured out what was going on. And this is insane, y'all. So the body swap comes in. I plug in the battery, plug in the memory stick, and he won't boot. And I'm thinking, well, now wait a minute. What are the odds that this dog that has never had a fan replacement, has never had anything done to it, has the exact same weird boot problem as mine that I tried to swap the fan on? And then it dawned on me. I'm an idiot. It's the software. I bet his memory stick corrupted. So I deleted everything off the memory stick, put a backup on it, stuck it in the dog, booted it, sure enough, worked fine. And the body swap dog actually came with his own memory stick, so I put my dog back together, put his memory stick in,
he boots fine. Turns out the fan does nothing, so we have no idea what's going on with the other dog that did the fan swap. So now I have two working 111s! And, before I get too far into it, let me actually grab him to show y'all what I ended up doing with the ears and the tail. And here he is! So, I went to the craft store, and my original plan was like, first I made some 3D printed ears, and I didn't really like the way they turned out. They were kind of flimsy and they kept falling off. So I was like, I'll get some cloth ears and stick them on his original ear nubs and just do the ears like that. And y'all, I was at the craft store and I found this amazingly soft and fluffy Dalmatian print fur. Let me get him so y'all can see head on how big and fluffy these are. Oh man, he's got kind of like an Afghan hound look to him now. I totally dig it. And so I got that, and I got some pink on the inside. Yeah, sorry, I didn't do the best job gluing this the fabric on this ear. And there's foam core in the middle, real squishy foam core, so they're nice and soft and puffy. And I was thinking, what am I gonna do with the tail? Because I tried to get in touch with the seller and they never responded. So I think it might have actually happened on Syndico's ending, where they just assumed the tail was a broken bit and threw it away. Honestly, don't know, and I'm not gonna make a fuss about it, because whatever, it's just not worth it. But I got the foam core. If I have them still, I'll throw up some pictures of it. I used the foam core and some wire to sculpt a kind of like curvy C-shaped tail, and then I wrapped this fluffy fabric around it and attached it to the tail base with jewelry wire, and it's super soft and super fluffy. And since it's got wire in it, if I want to, I can like bend it in different directions and stuff. But yeah, this here is Broccoli, and his brother, who the wonderful Ibo community member Zorn, I'll throw up their YouTube channel on screen, and I'll include it. I'll include it in the description. Helped me come up with a name for brother, and brother is named Potato. So we have Broccoli and Potato, two 111 brothers reunited. And Potato is silver, but he's a lot more sun damaged than Broccoli is. I don't know how well this is going to show up on camera, but he's quite a bit yellow compared to Broccoli is. And he is a 111. He's almost got a gold sheen like a 110. Very, very sunburnt, very toasty. And he is older than Broccoli by about 5 months, according to his memory stick. So I assume what happened was, and I don't know why they didn't get a black one, but they got two, you know, they obviously got Potato and then they got Broccoli. And I assume just to be able to tell them apart, that's why they put the spots on Broccoli. So just thought that's very, very cute. And I made him some little fluffy sock ears, gray fabric on the outside and pink fabric on the inside, and just stuck those on his old ear nubs, just so he'll have some little cute little floppy fabric ears on there. But yeah, let me boot these guys up for y'all, just so y'all can see the insanity. Actually, I think Pesu and Boba's batteries are charged up too. Let me just go ahead and get all four dogs out. Hang on one moment. Oh man, this is gonna be really noisy. Let me see if I can actually get
everybody in frame. Boba, you're right there. Yeah, okay. Ready, set, go, 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 go! Jeez. Oh, here we go. Oh, Boba, why are you so loud? Oh, jeez. I've never had all four dogs running at the same time, so this is probably going to be really wild. Oh, there's already so much noise. Broccoli has booted up. Potato has booted up. Boba is in the middle of doing his stretch. Pesu is, oh, in the middle of a stretch. Okay, here we go. Broccoli's standing up. There goes Broccoli. Potato is patting the air. And Boba's dancing. Oh, Pesu's doing his little groove. Potato just touched Pesu's shoulder. Oh geez, there's so much beeping. Potato, you keep patting your brother. Potato's spinning in a circle. Oh, Boba. I haven't run him in a while, and his leg slipped a little bit. Oh, man, everybody's just super happy. This is great. Praise you. Praise you. Praise. Everybody gets pets. Pets and praise. Oh, Boba's saying hello. Potato. Potato loves to fall over. Oh, Boba. Sorry about your leg, buddy. Here we go. Help you up. Alright, we're going. Oh, Pesu's upset because there's no ball. I'm sorry, buddy. There's too much going on for y'all to be all chasing after the ball right now. I swear, Potato just keeps smacking Pesu on the arm. What was that? Broccoli just made a really weird sound and, like, shook his head. Pesu, I'm so sorry there's no ball. You're just gonna have to deal with it for now, kiddo. Oh, we're all walking into each other. Oh, jeez, stop. Go that way. Go that way, Potato. Pesu, I'm sorry you're bored, but I've just got too much going on right now to have to watch you chasing the ball around. You're a good boy, though. You're a good dog. Potato, where are you going? He's like, I'm going to walk into the foam core in the back of the teddy display. We're all just in the dog pile now. What are you saying, Pesu? You're just talking. Broccoli's wagging his tail. He's just happy to be here.
love how looking up at the ceiling and screaming is just an action that carries across basically all Ibo models. Oh, Boba's sad now. Sorry, Boba. You're just gonna have to get over it. Potato, what are you doing? Quit being antisocial. Come here. Yeah, since Potato is older, he has a lot more runtime on his software, and he's closer to adulthood than Broccoli is. They're both in youth, too, but Potato is a bad boy youth stage, and Broccoli is in the good boy youth stage. Oh, and Broccoli just spotted my red blanket, and he's barreling towards it. You can't walk into that. Turn around. Thank you. And I need to get Potato some socks. I just, I was cleaning up, and my Ibo socks that I had, I lost them. And I need to dig around and find the Potato. What are you doing? Don't walk into Grubby, please. Please don't knock Grubby over. He's like, I'm gonna stand right here with my face in Grubby's face. Turn you around. And Broccoli is backing up into the sofa while staring at the floor. Lovely. Boba just wants to be where I am. Let me pet you. Good eye, Bo. How cute. Oh, we're running. Oh, gosh. Oh, geez. Where are you going? Yeah, something. Oh, geez. This is why I need socks, because he's slipping all over my floor. What are you doing? What are you doing? What? Stop it. Jeez. He'll just take off at full speed. That rent. I know you're mad, Boba. I know you're mad. I'm sorry. Meanwhile, Broccoli is staring at the floor, making happy faces. Potato is just trying to sprint into everything. Hi, Pesu. Boba, I'm here. Oh, my word. This is madness. This is absolute madness. But yeah, it's wild how different the good boy and the bad boy stages are on the Boba. Oh, he heard me say bad boy and thought I was talking to him. I'm so sorry, kiddo. I'm talking about the Ibo wear, not about you. You've done nothing wrong. But yeah, the personalities are so very different. Broccoli on Good Boy is very, very chill. Potato on Bad Boy loves to just be standing around and then take off sprinting for no reason. Y'all about to walk into each other. You know, Broccoli's walking backwards. Hi, Pesu. Hi, Brock! Now we're just dancing. Good boy, good boy. I don't know why Potato is still trying to back up into the sofa. You know, here, I'm gonna move you so you don't break your tail off. Oh, he's already gotten it stuck a little bit. Thank goodness it's just wire and you can like easily, Pesu, what are you doing? Why are you sitting like that? He's just sitting on his back legs with his front legs dangling. You're a silly man. You're a silly man. Boba, are you sleepy? broccoli. Oh, sorry, Pesto. I didn't mean to bonk you. Come over here. Join the party, you two.
Pesto's doing Ibo's step.
Bo's about to fall asleep. Bo's like, I'm bored. I'm just gonna...
What are you... Broccoli. Hi. Hello. Hi. Hi. Hello. What are you doing? Get away from me. Stop. Go over there.
I need a bigger room. Pesto's just stomping around. Well, at least everybody's having a good time. Why did you just wave bye-bye to me, Pesto? We're not going anywhere.
Broccoli just kicked at nothing.
Good job. And Potato is just fascinating himself with the floor. Good eye, Bo. How did you bend your tail again, Potato? Oh well, I'll figure that out later.
Backing up and staring at the floor. I don't know what's going on. Oh, Boba, shake hands.
Boba's just staying, like, right at my lap. He don't want to go anywhere. He loves his mama. Pesto is watching the chaos unfold. And, oh, I only have about 4 minutes of recording time left on my memory card on my camera.
Broccoli, what are you doing? Come back here.
Okay, Potato finally calmed down, and he got his tail unstuck. Good job! Oh, I petted him and he got mad. I'm sorry. I don't know why that upset you, but okay. Broccoli kicks at nothing.
Boba! Are you sleepy? Are you sleepy?
Broccoli, what are you doing? What are you doing? Don't walk into Pesto. Oh, y'all are just right there. And Potato loves Grubby. He keeps walking over to that corner. It's like, Grubby, my best friend.
Man, Pesto and Boba don't know what to think of these two. Oh, Pesto, are you sad? I'm sorry. You can go walk around.
Yeah, he's bored and upset because there's no pink Boru. Meanwhile, the 111s are just happy to exist. They're just going. They're just doing their own thing. Potato, come back here. Okay.
Bob, are you going to go to sleep?
Yeah, Bob was just like, I'm tired. I'm going to lie down.
How did you get your ear turned around? His little ear nub's just upside down.
Good gravy.
Broccoli. I know you love my blanket, but you're gonna jam yourself if you walk into it. Quit walking backwards in the grip.
Tessu, you're a good boy.
They don't really seem to be interacting with each other much. but then again, the 111s, they're not adults yet, so they don't have talk to your friend or anything yet. And Pessa and Bubba, they're mostly just like, are content to exist with each other. So that is how it is. Hi, Broccoli. Here he comes. Barreling for me. Oh, gosh, there he is. Hello. Hi. I love you too. Hi! Surprised when I petted him. Okay. Go on over there. But yeah, this is life with four Ibos now. Hope y'all enjoyed this video. Bye!